In today's video, I'm going to teach you how to install Haas Stainless Axis pivot end stops in wood post. We post a ton of really helpful cable railing tutorials and pro tips here on our YouTube channel, so be sure to hit that subscribe button. The first step in this install will be to grab your hole marking template and mark your end or corner posts for the pilot holes that you'll be drilling for your axis pivot end stops. Once your holes are marked, grab your drill and make sure that it's set to its highest speed setting. Using a 1/8 inch bit, drill the pilot holes that are needed for your end stops at each mark approximately 2 inches into your post. Go ahead and repeat this process for all of the marks on the post. Your axis pivot end stops are going to be composed of 5 different parts. You have your axis pivot receiver, a stainless steel decking screw, an axis pivot eye, an axis swage stud, and an axis pivot receiver pin. The next step in this install is to mount your axis pivot receivers to your post. Start off by securing a T20 star bit into your drill and set your drill to its lowest speed setting. Pass the stainless steel mounting screw through the axis pivot receiver and then drive the screw and receiver into the post. Continue drilling until the receiver fits snug up against the post. Use a flathead screwdriver to rotate the receiver in whatever orientation is needed for the run. Repeat this process for all of your remaining pivot receivers at the post. With your receivers now installed, the next step in the process will be to attach each of your pre-cut cables to the receivers. Locate your axis pivot receiver eyes and swage studs and then pre-thread them together as you see here. Then insert each of your pre-cut cables into your axis swage studs. Make sure when doing this that the cable is seated at the back of the swage cavity. With your axis swage studs fixed at the end of your cables, grab your swaging tool and then swage on each stud for each cable in the run. Once your swage stud is properly aligned in the die, close the handles of the swager to make your first swage. Then slightly open the handles, rotate the stud about 90 degrees, and then make your second and last swage on the stud. Remember when swaging to position the die of the swager within the swage area on the stud. Repeat this process for all of the cables and swage studs for the run. Once your axis swage stud and pivot receiver eye have been swaged onto the end of your cable, insert the cable into the slot in the receiver and secure it in place with a pivot receiver pin. Use a flathead screwdriver to tighten the pin in place. Once you've completed this process for the remaining end stops, you'll be ready to attach your cable to the tensioning fitting at the opposite end of the run. If you feel like the Axis system is right for you, then feel free to click through some of our other Axis component installation videos. If you have any questions about Axis pivot end stops, then drop us a comment below. And if you found this video tutorial helpful, then be sure to give it a like. I'm Tyler with Haas Stainless. Thanks for watching.